Mix 96.1. It's Russell, Rush, and JoJo. We just got put on hold by the Jonas Brothers manager. What the hell?
Why?
Oh, hold on. What's that? Oh, he's back on the line. Okay. Hello?
Hello?
Joe.
Russell, how you doing, man?
Hey, dude. I don't know if you remember us from when you were here. You may remember when you actually made fun of JoJo.
Yeah, Joseph.
Oh, I did.
You look, Joseph, you need to settle down, all right?
Yes, by the way, should we refer to you as Joseph? We were just told, we said Joseph Jonas is on the phone. Like, oh, should we refer to him as Joseph?
You know, a lot of parents and people refer me as Joseph. My mom, I think, is the only one that calls me Joseph Adam. Usually that she calls me that when I'm in trouble.
I was going to say, I wondered, yeah.
Yeah.
So she'll be like, Joseph Adam, across the room. And
if you're ever in trouble during this interview, I'm going to call you Joseph Adam.
Jose Adam.
Only if I'm in trouble, though.
Yeah, definitely. Here's the deal, man. I was like, you know, I get to interview and talk to everybody, so this may be the weirdest interview you've ever done. I've come up with none of these questions because I turned it over to your fans.
Oh, really?
So these are all questions that were emailed to me. We had something like 1,500 questions, and I've cherry-picked kind of the best ones.
Okay. All right. Go for it.
We'll go into here. The number one question, this is one that was asked by multiple people. We got to get right down to it. Are you guys all single?
We are single. You know, it's kind of hard on tour because you travel so much that you don't really get, you can't really have, like, say, a girlfriend in the city.
Right.
So.
Well, somebody wondered, somebody heard that you were dating JoJo.
You know what? I'm not into guys.
Well, neither am I, Joseph Adam.
Oh, he's in trouble.
No, you know what? I was actually helping her through the snow, and her friend or whoever, somebody took pictures, and they got on the internet. So really, we're not dating, though we're good friends, and we're, I think we're, hopefully we're going to see her soon. I think she's going to come to a show of ours, so.
Well, that's cool. Somebody else, actually, several people wanted to know if it was ever true, because they said that Nick denied it, but Miley mentioned it, that they were dating at some point, Nick and Miley, but did they date, or was that just kind of a rumor on tour?
You know, rumor, because they were just good friends, and but it's a rumor.
In a couple of years, let's be honest, they could be a huge power couple, though, right?
They definitely could. Yeah. I think maybe down the road, who knows?
They'll be taking over the world if that happens.
Somebody claimed to have seen pictures online of them kissing, but I've yet to find those pictures, so I think that's a rumor as well.
Yeah, doubtful.
This was an interesting question we got. Somebody wants to know if it's true that you almost crashed the tour bus. What happened there?
Oh, well, a previous bus driver of ours, he let me drive the bus.
Mistake?
Well, he let me park the bus. I can almost say I almost killed everybody in the bus.
Because
it's hard to parallel park in general.
Right.
With a tour bus, you can imagine. I was so close, I'm serious, to almost hitting this guy's car. And he was, like, outside watching. Of course, I'm having the best time, and I was honking the horn like crazy. And so, yeah. And I mean, it's kind of funny because I actually don't have my license yet.
And, you know, for somebody who doesn't have a license, definitely a large charter tour bus is the way to start.
Yeah,
you know?
Seriously.
There you
go.
Exactly.
That's the best way to learn
just,
right there.
Maybe I should just upgrade.
So what's this about Kevin thinking about leaving the band? Is that true?
Kevin leaving the band? Not true at all. He loves it. You know, we love what we do. I don't think he would want to leave it for anything. I think people have probably assumed that because he's getting older and he's 20. And he's almost going to be 21 soon.
Uh-huh.
But no, he loves it.
Do you guys still get nervous before your shows?
Actually, a few times I've gotten nervous, like, say, for a big award show or the first day of tour, because it's all so new. We have all these new things, and, like, you have all these secret parts of the show, and you're afraid that they might go wrong. Or
right, or somebody may fall on stage. Or...
Oh, exactly. Come on, man. It was an accident.
And you know, and I'm good at the falling stuff, so you never know what happens.
Oh, that was you. Oh, right. I forgot about that. I had no idea. It's going to be crazy tonight at the rodeo. Have you played at a rodeo before?
I have not played the rodeo. I'm wearing red, which is not really a good color to wear because I know, like, bulls, like,
yeah,
they charge the color red. So,
right, yeah.
We'll see how that goes.
May want to switch that up, yeah.
Yeah.
You're aware that the stage rotates in a circle, correct?
You know what? We're just practicing on it, and I was getting really dizzy.
So we could see another fall tonight then?
Oh, well, if you get lucky.
All right, we're going to do it. It's going to make headlines here in San Antonio. Hey, guys, thanks for coming back again. Thanks for calling in. Wish you all the success in the world, although you don't need any luck at all because you're already
hitting
the big time.
Thank you for all the support, guys. You guys are awesome. We love your radio station.
Here we go. Jonas Brothers, When You Look Me in the Eyes, Mix 96.1.
If the heart is always searching, can you ever find a home? I've been looking for that someone. I'll never make it on my own. Dreams can take the place of loving you. There's gotta be a million reasons why it's true. When you look me in the eyes and tell me that you love me, gonna tell you that I love you in the best way that I can. Sugar.